First time green texting, felt I had to get this off my back to let at least someone hear it. Me 2 years ago. Parents own cabin in northern Saskatchewan. Yes, I am northern Canada cuck, fuck off. Decide I want to spend time by myself up there, parents agree because they want me out of their attic. Been really into expats little while, so I found the idea of being by myself and isolated with whatever is out there in northern forest oddly comforting. Drive up there late November, stocked up on food to last a few months. Leave my phone at home since I only use it for internet related stuff. Cabin has electricity and a dish, no internet, but all my video are offline anyway. Bring rifle as well for hunting. Cabin has basic rectangular layout with an extension added on when my sister and I were born, to add extra room for us on vacations there. Mostly made out of wood except for tin roof on extension. Unpack my shit and chill when show up. Cabin is really close to the tree line. Very small clearing it was built on. Others would find this claustrophobic, I find it comforting. Like I said, oddly relaxed when it comes to the vaguely threatening like hex. First night I chill and listen to the sounds of animals as I fall asleep. No TV, just relaxing and settling into my new environment. Hear cow moos off in distance, pretty chill. First day get all my winter clothes on and head out into the woods. Stay close by the trees where the snow is mildly easier to walk through. I don't go out by any major clearings because snow's too deep. Reminded of all the times I walked through these woods as a kid with family. Decide to get out further and travel in parts I never went before. Parents would never tell us where we could and couldn't go, just never got around to it when I was younger. Hear the cow moos off again in the distance. Hell yeah, maybe I can get up close and have a good look at it. Moose are kind of dangerous up here since they're not familiar with people, but I figure I could climb a tree if it charges for some reason. Walk to where the call is coming from. Sound doesn't get any louder, but I figure that it must be walking away from me. Can't find any moose tracks, so I decide it's too far away to even chase after. Only like 7 hours of daylight at this time of year or something, so I start walking back. This is not the kind of place you want to get lost in. Once back home, start to think about the whole thing. Consider myself paranoid. Cook dinner and go to bed. Things went on quietly for the next few weeks. Found a rotting bull moose with all the skin on its head chewed off, explain it away as maggots or other small animals. Tried to go hunting for deer and anything else, but could never find tracks despite all the calls I heard at night. Mostly female for some reason. Always tell myself they must just be out further than I usually venture. One day go out and actually manage to snag a small buck. Fuck yeah. PNG. Never shot one by myself before, so I have no idea how to take care of the meat. Decide I'd leave it till tomorrow and butcher it when I wake up. Go full retard mode and leave it hanging outside as to not stink up the cabin. Next day go out and there are fucking blights taken out of it. God fucking damn it. JPG. Some animal got to it first and mangled the poor bastard. Really went at it on the head for some reason. All the skin was chewed off. Couldn't recognize the bite marks, but decided to stop walking out so far into the woods. Start to wonder how I got a male buck if all the calls I heard were female. I know what calls mean what, and these were Mohr long drawn indicating female. Paranoia sets in since I got anxious about random shit. Quickly make myself forget about it since I promised myself I'd stay for the full few months and not go home early. Next night can't sleep because of anxious thoughts. Insomnia.gif. Begin to hear a very slight noise. It was a very quiet night, so I would be able to hear something outside if anything was there. Sound is almost rhythmic, but I can't make out what it is. Eventually it gets louder as if the sound itself is frustrated. Realize something must be making it. Sit up and listen to what has now become an audible scratching noise, like something being scraped over wood. Sound travels all the way across the cabin, past where I'm sleeping in the extension, and all the way around again. The second time it passes the extension, it stops right where I am sitting in the bed for just a moment and then continues. This goes on for a few minutes then stops. Pass out from exhaustion. The next day I have to convince myself what happened wasn't a dream. Begin to form an idea in my mind of some intelligent animal. It can't just be coincidence. In the middle of the day I build up the courage, go outside and see what happened. Scratches in the snow-covered walls, not enough to wreck the wood but enough to see a pattern of scratches that were more than a few feet above the ground, as if something did them purposefully. This wasn't just some dumb animal. Finally decide to take a look at my door. The scratches were serious on the wooden door, as if someone with gigantic fingernails spent hours scraping at it. Tripping balls on fear at this point. Whatever it was intelligent enough to tell the door was the way in but predatory enough to use circling as an intimidation tactic. Come to the logical conclusion that whatever this was, it must have been the same thing that mauled my fucking buck. Finally decide to look at the footprints. Whatever the fuck this thing was, it certainly was not a bear. Begin to realize something. There were no footprints around the cabin, just ones leading up to it and leaving. The thing was climbing around my walls and dragging its nails to create the scratches. Definitely not a bear. Just want to fucking get out of there at this point. Sun starts to go down and storm clouds start moving in. I've been out here for 2 hours just looking at all this shit in awe. Can't leave in a blizzard or in the dark, so I lock myself the fuck in the get into bed with gun. Mind starts racing when night hits. Wind is howling outside, but off in the distance I hear that goddamn cow moose call again. Begin to put two and two together. Whatever the fuck this thing was, it calling male animals and by mimicking female mating calls. Must have preferred male animals since they have more meat. When I left that goddamn buck outside, it could tell I was here. The first full day I spent here and was trailing that cow moose call, it must have been right fucking above me in a tree. Train of thought was stopped when I heard that goddamn scratching noise again. I can barely make it out because of the loud ass blizzard, but I recognize it. Either it sees me as an alpha predator rival or as prey, and at this point I don't know which is worse. This goddamn thing is insanely good at climbing because I hear the sounds of feet on a wooden roof. Storm is so loud I can't make out exactly where the feet are on the roof, just hearing the sounds of feet on wood and snow faintly. Suddenly the sound changes to feet on tin. Right fucking above me. JPG. I can't handle this shit anymore, but I can't leave because that's exactly what it wants. The sound of banging on tin go on for what feels like hours as the storm rages on. Eventually it goes away, thank God. Blizzard begins to die down too. Can hear things more clearly outside. Was not fucking prepared for what happened next. Hear woman's voice outside. Not making any discernible words, almost babbling, moaning like it's orgasming. Oh no, you fucking don't, you barefoot demon, you're not tricking me like you did all those moose and deer. Sounds very close, at least within the tree line. Grab a big ass flashlight and open one of the unlocked windows. Shine it outside where the sound is coming from. See 7 foot tall slim muscular build at first, then eyes adjust to what I'm looking at. Face is a hideous interpretation of a human's, like if you described to an alien what a person looked like and told them to draw it, then fed the drawing to dogs. Nose was turned up like it was facing directly at me. Eyes weren't sunken like one would suspect, they were bulbous and protruding with gigantic pupils. Eyes looked almost swollen. The best way to describe the mouth was like the one on the mouth of Saw Erin from Return of the King, round and way too big. Face was shaped like baboon's face, very oval-like with a heavy brow ridge. The only difference being was that it was incredibly flat and its forehead was huge. It pulled its lips back to bare its teeth in a predatory fashion. Except all it looked like was as if it was smiling at me. Its hands were a grotesque combination of sloth and human hands. In one of its hands it held the head of a buck. Had all the skin on it chewed off like before. This was a goddamn threat. After getting a good look at it, I take a shot at it. Not sure if I hit it since the flashlight dropped, but I could see it drop the head and run off into the woods. Grabbed the flashlight and pointed it in its direction again and could barely make up the shape of it climbing a tree in seconds and jumping off from one tree to another. Stayed up the rest of the night, left in the morning. Came home early and told my parents I was feeling lonely as an excuse to come back. Never told them about it because they would have accused me of taking drugs. This is probably the only time I'll ever tell this story anyways. I don't believe in magic or forest demons because I'm not a complete retard. I believe what I saw was a grotesque failure of evolution. Some mutated fucking animal that managed to survive long enough out there. Not giving it a stupid name like other autists do when they see shit on this board. I'm never going back to fucking northern Saskatchewan as long as I live.